Greetings, world. We are Anon DK. We typically hear much about the Bundy family regarding the serial killer Ted Bundy, TV shows, and now the recent Patriot movement in America. The family is very public and easy to find. The controlled opposition Patriot movement started a few years ago by the CIA and the Bundy family, helping to create the civil war taking place in the USA currently. As we keep telling you, the elite always play both sides. The Bundys of today are in the spotlight, so we will not linger on them. To move on, other names they have used and merged with are Frazier, Blackmer, Hitchcock, MacGeorge, Bond, Bunt, Bronte, Bean, MacBean, McVeigh, Bay, and many others. Let's take a look from Harvey Hollister Bundy. Born in 1888, he became a high member of Skull and Bones, naturally. He was special assistant to Secretary of War Henry Stimson, also Skull and Bones, law clerk for Justice Oliver Wendell Holmes, and intricately involved in the Manhattan Project as he worked for the Pentagon and many other high offices at military bases like Panama and banks. He was chairman of the Carnegie Endowment for International Peace and many, many other organizations. He married Harvard President Abbott Lawrence Lowell's niece Catherine Lawrence Putnam from the very prominent, elite, wealthy Putnam bloodline seen in Boston. They had William Bill Putnam Bundy and MacGeorge. Under President Hoover, while he worked for the Secretary of War, he also became special legal assistant to the Secretary of Treasury. He died in 1963. The Bundy family, like the rest of them, are given their public story, an image to keep up. The Patriot. All while taking their orders from the ones they claim to be against. It is just deception and lies. One easy way to see the truth is to look at their education. If you haven't figured it out by now, top colleges and top careers are all a false front to keep you thinking and believing that they are better than you. They keep themselves separated from humanity and fool us into believing they are separated because they are smarter than we are and more valuable than we are. The colleges are where they get involved deeper into the clubs such as Skull and Bones, Bohemian Club, the Round Table, and the like. The gig the elites run is perfect for the ignorant, who pay them to mind control their children, and push their children to accept it. After all, Ivy League must be the best because it costs so much. Slaves promoting slavery, astonishing. Once you really see that governments and corporations and universities and the like are simply illusions, a false facade for the elite to hide behind, you will see how powerful you really are. William Bundy became an intelligence expert and analyst, as well as attorney for the CIA. He was intimate with the planning of the Vietnam War and was foreign affairs advisor for Kennedy and Johnson. After he retired, he became a historian of foreign affairs and taught at MIT and Princeton until he died in 2000. He married Mary Aitchison and they had Michael, Christopher and Carol. His little brother Mac George, called Mac, became the national security advisor to Kennedy and Johnson. Married to Mary B. Lothrop, they had Stephen, Andrew, William and James. He was president of the Ford Foundation and was one of the chief designers for the Vietnam War. He was professor of Harvard, member of CFR along with Dwight Eisenhower, Alan Dulles, Richard M. Bissell, Jr., and George Key, and worked on the Marshall Plan, involved in the Bay of Pigs false flag and Cuban Missile Crisis. The US government has always considered itself dictator of the world. Any ruler of any country who does not like this is overthrown or killed. His skull and bones nickname is Odin. Also, he was the chairman for the 303 committee. Mac George Bundy went to Yale, where he was initiated into the skull and bones. Mac George then went to Harvard. After this, Mac George joined the army as a private at 23 years old. In a year was promoted to captain and placed on staff to plan the logistics and other details of the invasion of Sicily and the Normandy invasion. Do you think the same speed would apply to you if you could join any of their clubs? How can a newbie without experience have the experience to know how much supplies, etc. are needed for a certain operation? Bear in mind that these calculations are for battles in which the wrong combination of supplies could mean death or defeat for a unit. But this is America. There is no value on life. Of course, what is shown here is less than what is listed in the document, which is itself only a very short outline for you to use to find out more. We cannot put every detail into one document. We leave many discoveries open for you to find and expand your own knowledge. We merely give you the tools and light the path. You must do the walking. Because of certain events, Mac George Bundy was included in Nixon's enemies list and was suicided by heart attack in 1996. Mac George was also MJ-12, and both brothers, besides being lead members of CFR, Skull and Bones and other groups, were Bilderbergers. So, Harvey Hollister's grandfather, Solomon Jr., was a district attorney and a congressman. Born in Oxford, New York on May 22, 1823, he married Roxara Hitchcock and had Elizabeth Roxanne Bundy. Then he married Elizabeth Ann Mac George and had son Mac George and Nathan O. Like most of the top families, their graves are marked in the Riverview Cemetery with a looming obelisk. Elizabeth M.C. George's father was famous Reverend Horatio T.M.C. George. Solomon Bundy Jr.'s grandfather William was the unification of the Smith and Bundy bloodlines in 1748. If we follow the Bundys back to John Bundy, born 1617 in England, he came to New Hampshire, U.S. and settled in Massachusetts. He was married to Martha Chandler and then Ruth Bundy. His offspring were Samuel, Mary, James 1 and 2, Martha, Patience, and Sarah. Now let's look at the British Bundys. John Bundy's dad, also John, was born 1590 in Nottinghamshire, England. He was also known as John Bean. John Bundy Bean was married to M. Edwards Palmer. The name is still prominent in the family, for example the FMC Corporation. If we go back, tracing the Beans with all of their spellings through Nottinghamshire, York, Otts, all the way back to 1210, where we see the Bean who jumped the border. He became a magistrate in Aberdeen, Scotland. Now following the Bundy, Bean, line back in Scotland, the first reported Bean came from the MC Beans, also spelled Mac Bean, which came from the MacBain family in Aberdeenshire. The MacBain symbol is a red hand on a white shield. Notice how many families in the lower elites have the colors red and white for their crests. Remember the color orders and how they relate to status of the families. These were the sod bearers for the Chatter clan's chief. The name means son of the fair lad. Sod translates into council, roughly meaning a group. As we see through the line so far, lawyers, advisors, they seem to be the chosen council still. If we look at this word just a bit closer, the first recorded name Sodi, Sodai, or Basidia means Council of Yah. It's interesting to learn the definitions of the names, since that's the reason for the names in the first place. The name Bean in Old Gaelic means hill or peak. The old Bundi clan known as Bean is actually quite important to our history in this document. The Chatter clan was called the Chatter Confederation and was different from every other Scottish clan. The clan had 12 separate clans within it who each had their own chief. They were recognised under Scottish law, but were united under one main chief of the confederation for mutual solidarity. These clans can be easily traced. The 12 clans in the confederation are MC Bean, also known as Yean, MacPherson, Farquharson, MacTomas, Shaw, MacIntosh and MacPhail were related by blood. The other clans not related but included were the Davidson, MacLean, MacQueen, MacIntyre, MacGillivray, MacAndrew. De Morban, also known as Donald MacBain, Duolby, Donald the Fair, was King of the Scots in 1093. Donald III was represented in the Duolby character in Shakespeare's Macbeth. The line can then be easily traced back to Cynaid Mac Ailpin, also known as Kenneth Mac Alpi, King of the Picts, the first King of the Scots in 841. Kenneth's father Alpi, son of Ake, was killed in Galloway about 836 AD, after he had entirely destroyed and devastated the land, so the story goes. Then the Kingdom of the Scots was transferred to the Kingdom of the Picts. From here we will leave you to discover the remaining few centuries. It is easy to follow the lines. Up to the recent past of the Bundis. In keeping with the advisory role of the family, Jonas Mills Bundy was key advisor to Presidents Grant, Garfield and Chester Arthur. In 1957, a wing or branch of the Illuminati under Oasis, a leading mafia family, kidnapped the self-created billionaire and genius, Howard Hughes, and practiced what is named Hegelian philosophy. A thesis is set up, antithesis set up, then out of the conflict of the two comes the synthesis. This is how the elite operate today: create a problem, get the reaction, provide the solution. If an Illuminati demand isn't met, then the business would be burned or the businessman hurt. The mafia would introduce themselves as protectors for the businessman from the extortionists. Finally, when the businessman begins paying the mafia for protection, that completes the cycle. The Illuminati have always been doing this tactic. We saw the obvious use of it in France when the trains were bombed by US agents, after the French decided not to join the US against ISIS. The day after the bombing, they made a point to announce to the world, loudly, that they were against ISIS and joined the war. Same happened with Russia's plane being shot down by US, and the list is truly endless. Eric Bundy was put in charge of Howard Hughes' real name, Elwain Rector. Hughes was kept in near isolation by the families, who used double Brooks Randall for appearances, because he would not comply with the family's wishes to buy him out. He was a genius, filled with new ideas but unwilling to sell them. Similar to Tesla in some ways. He knew, like those who have been murdered before him and since, that ideas are priceless and knowledge is power. This is what the elite fear most. Ideas and knowledge. This is what we fight for. Knowledge should be free. The public was told Hughes died in 1971. Eric Bundy was his overseer. Robert Mayhew and Lou Russell were also in charge of Hughes, and the three worked together in the assassination of Kennedy. Hughes was kidnapped, tortured, starved and drugged for many months until he was thrown out of a plane into the ocean by his captors. That is how the world really works. You will never be told in the news what is truly going on. It is only there to keep you distracted from the elite. Now, Continuing in 1906, the Panama Canal is constructed by De Lesseps, according to Saint Simon's New World Order plans. The Panama Canal was owned and operated by the United States government, until treaties, ratified 1977, provided for its operation by a Panama Canal Commission until December 31, 1999. As written, the year 2000, Panama assumed full responsibility for its management, operation and maintenance. In 1909, Harvey Hollister Bundy Sr. became a lawyer, like his father, grandfather, and great-grandfather. Harvey was in Skull and Bones and had five children, three who were also in the Skull and Bones order. Moy D. Collins was state superintendent of schools in Georgia. He went to Bob Jones College sometime after 1938, was a Freemason, a Grand Master of the Georgia Grand Lodge of Odd Fellows, associate editor of the Georgia Odd Fellows News, and editor of Atlanta's Masonic Magazine. He was in Eastern Star, and other affiliated Masonic groups. He lived at the Capitol Building in Georgia and was a pastor of Friendship Baptist Church for his lifetime. Edward S. Van Dewey was a prominent surgeon, born in Syracuse, New York. He went to Princeton University and got his MD at Syracuse University. During World War I, he was in the U.S. Army Medical Corps in France, as a major then as a lieutenant colonel. Van Dewey attended the Unitarian Church, which is deeply associated with Wicca. He also associated with the Liberal Presbyterians, another oxymoron. These word plays do well to decipher and redefine words. During this time, Coleman DuPont went in business with President Taft's brother Charles P. Taft of Skull and Bones to build MC Alpi Hotel in New York City. Horace Taft was also member of the Order of Skull and Bones. The Taft family helped start the Skull and Bones Order. Coleman bought New York Equitable Life Assurance Society, which was America's largest insurance company. Coleman belonged to the Rittenhouse in Philadelphia and was the director of Union National Bank, the president of Central Coal and Iron Company, and much more. We see the Round Table groups appear during 1910, reconfiguring themselves from the other branches of Illuminati subgroups. Abe Bailey and the Astors were the main supporters of the Round Table groups. Join us next time and see how history unfolds. Expect it.